You're in for a treat today. Here we are at the Rolling Fork Farm in Gravel Switch, Kentucky. This place is spectacular. Now, I don't care whether you're into horses or cattle or tomatoes. They raise a lot of tomatoes here. They bake bread. If you're into income property, to have an organic farm for income, or you just want a getaway place, this has got it all. All the land is usable. It's really key. It's so important and so hard to find today. All this land is usable. It's 30 acres, a little over 30. One time I said to a lady, I said, well, it's 30. No, she says 30.4. And I said, well, you know, what's 0.4? She says, that's all I live on now. So I think it's kind of a funny little story. But so it's a little over 30 acres. The road comes up. This is all publicly maintained. And there's city water back here. You've got municipal water, which is great, because anytime the power goes out, you still got water. And the views are tremendous. So 30 acres, 2,800 square foot house, 3-bedroom, 2-bath. Look at this beauty. I know you're gonna like it. Wait till you see this room here. It's like a sunroom. Wait till you see it. It's the showcase of the house. It's got wood heat, and it's got a regular heater as well, but then it's got this outdoor wood furnace. Now, what they do here is they pick up some scraps and little branches that break and things like that on the farm. But you can have this block wood, which is all like 8 by 8 pieces, maybe a foot and a half long. You can have that delivered for about $200, $250. It would be more than enough to heat your whole place for the winter. So it's a hot water system, and it circulates the antifreeze or hot water or whatever back and forth, provides your domestic hot water, provides heat for the greenhouse all year, and heat for the house. So anyway, that's wonderful. Keeps all the smell and the mess and the dust outside, and it's like new, and they can tell you all about it. It's all stainless steel. Very cool. All right, we're gonna go inside, but I kind of wanted to show you this. The property line here, let me zoom out. The property line, see, there's like one or two swaths cut there with the hay machine. That's where the property line is, and it goes up to this spot right here on the road, and it goes down the road, includes that whole field. So you see that tree row there? That's the end of the property. It goes up and over way in the back. Very nice. There's some pine trees there that are included in the property, and that comes along that back line. Now, what's key about that field there is about 12 acres, and that 12-acre field can be subdivided off. You could build a house or two or three up in there, but you've got this road frontage, and Boyle County will let you subdivide that off back up there. So if you need a second house or a third house or just some potential retirement income where you need to lop off a piece of land, you can do that. And then the rest of the land is all out here out front, and then it goes behind the house and behind the barns, and there is a there's a very cool pond back here. So let me just show you the tomatoes real quick. You're gonna want to see this. So here are the koi ponds, and then there's a waterfall here. I'll show you more of that later. And then that pond is right there. You see the canoe and that rope swing. And then check out these tomatoes. This is so cool. I've always grown up in the country, but I've never seen tomatoes go up to 8 feet like this. Is this cool? They just picked another 400 pounds of tomatoes, and they get sent to CSAs and organic stores. It's a organic farm, and Dan can tell you more about that. But they got little babies growing here already, so I assume they've got tomatoes all year round. But how cool is this, right? And those rascals just go up. They grow up these strings. They're 8 feet tall. There's not many better smells than the smell of that tomato plant. Love that. And look at these. Aren't they gorgeous? Gorgeous. All organic. Nothing sprayed. Nothing in the ground. Just fertilizer. You know, real fertilizer. Not chemical fertilizer. Real stuff. Manure and compost and that sort of thing. And now we've come around back from the front of the house, and we come to this bread oven, which I think is the coolest. I'm just into that. Baking my own bread. I mean, pizza. 25 loaves will fit in here. This is a big oven. And look at this view. Can you imagine sitting out here, making your own bread, having a glass of wine? Here we go with the wine again, right? So, and then here's a party area. This is the shed, this is the machine shed. And then you've got, you know, for the lawnmower and all that sort of thing. But this is the party area. How cool is this? When I see this, I think of like a pool house. So wait till I show you over there. You're gonna really like that. So you've got a sink here and a grill, little refrigerator, TV, lighting. Super. And I'm not gonna show my wife this crepe myrtle because she loves crepe myrtle. Now, as you come back from the barn, that's where my truck's parked, the property line doesn't go too far behind that barn. And then it comes down here, not this fence, but there's another fence about 50, 75 feet on the other side. And that's the end of the property line, where that telephone pole, that power pole is. And then it shoots down here to this road, on the other side of the road, this is your road, and it shoots down to that point around there in that field. So 30 acres, that's a lot of land. Let's go on inside. Okay, here we go. Now, three bedrooms, two full baths, 2,800 square foot. This house is huge. It's got these old style cabinets, lots and lots of countertop, lots of cabinet space. And what I like a lot is this eat-in area. Look at this. There's your view. Can you imagine having coffee, looking at that every morning? And then of course, there's the bread oven right there. So you can be right out here, a lot of entertaining. Here's laundry, and I assume this is a laundry chute. And then you've got master closet there, right off of the bath. Wait till you see that, it's a walk-in guy. And then from the kitchen here, there's the front door. And you've seen pictures of the porch. With the doggy on the porch. Such a beautiful view. And then this is like a man's room. This is, he's got the fireplace, it's got the paneling, the beams on the ceiling, hardwood floors. This is just beautiful. So use it as a library or a cigar smoking room or whatever you want, but wait till you see, I'm gonna show you the millwork on the other side here. Raised panels, this arch, and this is my favorite room. Got wood stove. All tile floor, wood stove, and that rascal, I bet, will heat the whole house. Now you've got one of those outdoor wood furnaces here as well, and that heats the whole house and the greenhouse. And I'll talk to you more about that when I'm outside. But that's really a nice thing. But this wood stove here, you got the glass door, you can see it's like, you know, fireplace and wood stove, best of both worlds. But look at this. Look at this millwork. I'm really impressed with that. And the ceiling. So, the room of many windows. So in the wintertime, if you ever need to cheering up, you just come right on out here. It's so big, you can put a pool table here, or they have a ping pong table. Let's just pop outside here real quick. So here are the koi ponds. Here's that party area, the entertaining area. And you got koi ponds and a waterfall and everything. And there's the greenhouse right there, filled with tomatoes. Wait till you see those. I'm gonna take you out there as well. Okay, now, through this den, which is pretty big. Show you how big this is. Yeah, it's a big room. And then this bathroom here is great. It's got the wainscoting on the bottom and full one-piece tub and shower here. And I just love this openness here. This is really nice, light and airy feeling. Now these treads are oak, But I can't put my finger on this wood on the floor. It's maybe some kind of a nut wood. It's beautiful. What's going on here in the front? Is it a lazy day today? Snuggles. Dog's name is Snuggles. It's pretty funny. But here you're overlooking all your land. So property goes up against those trees. And that's a long way out there. I'm going to guess, I don't know, 800 feet or so. I mean, that's truly a guess. Might be 900, 700, I don't know. But it's far. I wouldn't want to walk it. But there is a walking trail cut with a lawnmower. And I don't know where it starts, but it goes all the way along back there. It's 7/10 of a mile. So you can go out and walk in the morning. And you're so far out here in the country. I mean, oh, just, it's God's country out here. This is God's place. Let's go back in. Okay, so as soon as you come in the front door, just to the left here is this very cool bathroom. You got cedar, which you can smell. Oh, that Western red cedar is just fantastic. Jet tub. And then check this out. Two or three steps down into the shower. And when I tell you, you can have six of your best friends in here, you can have six of your best friends. It's huge. How cool is that? And hopper. And then here's the walk-in. So, and these are with sensor lights, which is great because my wife always forgets to shut off her closet light. Drives me crazy, right? It's a short drive, I know, but this is with sensor. All the lights come on with a sensor. I love that. You don't have to fool with anything. And then right back out to the laundry room again from this side. Now, we saw outside, we saw that wood furnace. Well, let me just tell you what's going on here. You've got a central heat and air system here. It's geothermal. So you know how that works. It goes into the ground and it pulls heat from the ground, which is always at 58. Heat pumps work great, but once they get down below 35 or so, they don't work very well. The geothermal always is pulling from 58 degrees. So it's easy to heat or cool when you got a 58 degree constant. So that's like the best system you can get. Now let's add a layer of coolness on top of it and throw that wood furnace out there. There's the heat exchanger for you people who like all this geeking out on this stuff. There's the heat exchanger. So in these pipes are antifreeze and that run out to the wood stove, and it's got a coil there, and then the pump pumps it up through here, and then you've got the heat exchanger there. And it also runs the domestic hot water. So very cool, and you can truly live off the grid with a very light generator just running these circulator pumps. Anyway, the sellers can tell you more about it, Dan can tell you more about it, but I wanted to share that with you real quick. Okay, so there's the bathroom, master bath, and then here's the master bed. Serene. So you wake up in the morning, you open your eyes, and you look out over those fields. Remember those fields from outside? Just beautiful. Look at that. So let's go on upstairs. I'll show you what we got up there. We got two nice bedrooms in this airy feel. I love this. So this bedroom is all paneling, which not a big deal. If you like paneling, great. And if you don't like paneling, paint is cheap. And I'll show you what it looks like painted. There you go. Now, how cute is that for a little girl or someone who just likes pink? And that's just paint right on the paneling. Beautiful. Good solution if you don't like that dark paneling. All metal roof. Look at that. I love a tin roof. First of all, they don't ever seem to go bad. And another thing is, it sounds so nice with the rain on the tin roof. That's about living in the country. That's all part of it. One of my favorite places in this farm is this area back here. Of course, I got a lot of favorite places, like the bread oven that holds 25 loaves of bread or pizzas. I mean, gosh, can you imagine making your own pizza on a wood-fired oven? We got this playhouse, and it's a real house. It's got power and everything. See the screen door and the power? and the swing. Now, we've had a drought, so the pond is really low right now. But you've got this rope swing. How cool is that? Get up there and you just do a Geronimo. And it's got a canoe, and it's like a kidney shape, goes around to the barn. That's the end of the property. I have no idea what's on the other side, but I imagine it's thousands and thousands of acres that are untouched, unspoiled. This is one of those places that you're way out there, way out in the country. You know, you're way out in the country, but you're only, what, 15 minutes to Danville, 20 minutes to Danville. This is quite a beautiful thing. This is all koi ponds and waterfall and all that stuff. If you like that sort of thing, you're in for a treat. If you don't like that sort of thing, this would be a perfect, perfect place for a pool. Here we are, we're going down this road. The house is just behind me, and I'm gonna do some footage down there, but here's the compost and manure piles and all that stuff that you'd have with organic farming. 240 blueberry bushes. And more greenhouses down there will go on down there. They've got eggplant going. You know, these people make a living off of this farm. Of course, that's real subjective. So how do you, can you do the same thing? Well, it depends on how hard you work, what kind of products you have, so on and so forth. But that main greenhouse over there is heated. So last year, for instance, they sold vegetables and had income every month of the year. So we had a mild winter, which helped, and then that new system there with the heat, the heated greenhouse, really helped. So you had spinach and kale and chard and things like that all year round. So there's income the whole year. Amazing. Now, we were just up there, and they have their helpers here, interns from all over. Very interesting situation, very interesting people. But they just picked 440 pounds of tomatoes to go out today. So how cool is that? And that goes to like Whole Foods and places like that. So all certified organic. It's an interesting lifestyle. Absolutely, I'm so envious. Now you heard me mention these people make a living off this farm. You don't have to make a living off this farm to enjoy this. Do whatever you want with it. This is a certified organic income producing, like a truck farm or whatever you want to call it, where you're doing vegetables, all that stuff. They make bread. You do not have to do that here. You can just have a beautiful oasis. You can plant alfalfa here for your horses. But I did want to show you all the things. Why in a drought are all their plants flourishing? And that's because they've got all this irrigation line in here, and they irrigate out of the pond behind the house. So there's lines and lines all over, supplying water to these crops. I don't know if you can hear the birds or not. I mean, that's all you hear. You're out here. This is parsley. This is that wide parsley. Then you got curly parsley. Then they've got stuff. I have no idea even what some of that other stuff is. And it's getting late in the season. So not everything is all going at once. But then this other greenhouse is filled with plants as well. Then there's blackberry bushes, raspberries. You saw the blueberries up there. So anyway, we'll just keep driving around. I wanted to show you this view because it's kind of pretty. And also, I wanted to show you back here. And here again, hundreds of acres or thousands of acres, literally. Now the property line stops right at that first tree row. And that's gonna be about 600 feet from where I'm standing, 400 feet. And then beyond that is literally thousands and thousands of acres before you get to the next even building. So anyway, real pretty. Look at this. Mm-mm. I also wanted to point out this walking trail, 0.7 miles, and it goes all around the farm. And it's mowed. They keep it mowed with just a regular mower. It's maybe 3 feet wide or whatever. And it goes all around the farm so you can walk nice and early in the morning. Okay, here's this other greenhouse that I wanted to show you. Now this one, I believe, is not heated. I believe that. Oh, those babies would be on the table tonight. In fact, the people gave me some. So we're gonna pick some basil fresh out of the garden. We got tomatoes fresh, and we're gonna have ensalada caprese tonight. This road is all county maintained, even to the end. They turn the school bus right around there if you want. Now this road is, well, let me interrupt myself. Here you've got the fields, so you've got about 20 acres here, then you got 12 acres up on the hill, 30 acres altogether. And then this is the end of the property line here where this is mowed. You can see where they put in a couple swaths of with the hay bine or whatever they have here. And then these pine trees, real cool. Now this road, I want to show you this road. This road is 0.6 miles. So what's that? 6 times 500, 3,000 roughly, a little over 3,000 feet out to the main road. And so this is just one lane wide, but at the end of this road is the Forkland Community Center, and it's a real social thing out here. So you've got, of course, the Easter dinner and the Christmas thing, you know, they have a dinner and a fall festival and all that great stuff, but they also have art classes during the summer, and I'm sure other times where you can just walk down this road 0.6 miles to art classes. So you're way out in the country, organic farm, the whole thing, and you can walk to art classes. That's pretty special. And then just 20 minutes to Danville, which is very cosmopolitan. Let's go on up and I'll show you some more. I can show you this field here. This is that 12 acre field. We'll drive right up through there. Now here we are up in the back 12, in this field right here I showed you earlier. Then, as you know, you come in the road this way, and then you see that field that's mowed there. There's a little swath there. That's the property line. So it comes along the road, back in this corner here, behind that pole, along those trees. There's the road, and then it shoots back to that back line of trees, which you can see right there. It goes all the way back into that point, and then back and up and along around the barn like I showed you earlier. But I just wanted to give you a view. It's an overall view of the whole farm here. You can see how beautiful it is. The pond, which is like a kidney shape, just gorgeous. You can't see that when you're down there, but you sure can from up here. You have this beautiful maple and the house and the sheds and all that. But I'm here at the top of the hill. You talk about a building spot. This would be a building spot as well. So if you have need for another house or another family member, this is the spot for it. Look at this view up here. You got power right here. The power company will run electric for you for free. There's city water here. So you got everything. And then Danville's just right over there, not too far. Quite a beautiful thing. This is all koi ponds and waterfall and all that stuff. If you like that sort of thing, you're in for a treat. If you don't like that sort of thing, this would be a perfect, perfect place for a pool. Here we are, we're going down this road. The house is just behind me, and I'm gonna do some footage down there, but here's the compost and manure piles and all that stuff that you'd have with organic farming. 240 blueberry bushes. And more greenhouses down there. We'll go on down there. They've got eggplant going. You know, these people make a living off of this farm. Of course, that's real subjective. So how do you, can you do the same thing? Well, it depends on how hard you work, what kind of products you have, so on and so forth. But that main greenhouse over there is heated. So last year, for instance, they sold vegetables and had income every month of the year. So we had a mild winter, which helped, and then that new system there with the heat, the heated greenhouse really helped. So you had spinach and kale and chard and things like that all year round. So there's income the whole year, amazing. Now, we're just up there, and they have their helpers here, interns from all over. Very interesting situation, very interesting people. But they just picked 440 pounds of tomatoes to go out today. So how cool is that? And that goes to like Whole Foods and places like that. So all certified organic. It's an interesting lifestyle. Absolutely, I'm so envious. Now you heard me mention these people make a living off this farm. You don't have to make a living off this farm to enjoy this. Do whatever you want with it. This is a certified organic income producing, like a truck farm or whatever you want to call it, where you're doing vegetables, all that stuff. They make bread. You do not have to do that here. You can just have a beautiful oasis. You can plant alfalfa here for your horses. But I did want to show you all the things. Why in a drought are all their plants flourishing? And that's because they've got all this irrigation line in here, and they irrigate out of the pond behind the house. So there's lines and lines all over supplying water to these crops. I don't know if you can hear the birds or not. I mean, that's all you hear. You're out here. This is parsley. This is that wide parsley. Then you got curly parsley. And then they've got stuff. I have no idea even what some of that other stuff is. And it's getting late in the season. So not everything is all going at once. But then this other greenhouse is filled with plants as well. Then there's blackberry bushes, raspberries. You saw the blueberries up there. So anyway, we'll just keep driving around. I wanted to show you this view because it's kind of pretty. And also, I wanted to show you back here. And here again, hundreds of acres or thousands of acres, literally. Now the property line stops right at that first tree row. And that's going to be about 600 feet from where I'm standing, 400 feet. And then beyond that is literally thousands and thousands of acres before you get to the next even building. So anyway, real pretty. Look at this. Mm-mm. I also wanted to point out this walking trail, 0.7 miles, and it goes all around the farm. And it's mowed. They keep it mowed with just a regular mower. It's maybe 3 feet wide or whatever. And it goes all around the farm so you can walk nice and early in the morning. Okay, here's this other greenhouse that I wanted to show you. Now this one, I believe, is not heated. You're in for a treat today. Here we are at the Rolling Fork Farm in Gravel Switch, Kentucky. This place is spectacular. Now I don't care whether you're into horses or cattle or tomatoes. They raise a lot of tomatoes here. They bake bread. If you're into income property, to have an organic farm for income, or you just want a getaway place, this has got it all. All the land is usable. It's really key. It's so important and so hard to find today. All this land is usable. It's 30 acres, a little over 30. One time I said to a lady, I said, well, it's 30. No, she says 30.4. And I said, well, you know, what's 0.4? She says, that's all I live on now. So I think it's kind of a funny little story. But so it's a little over 30 acres. The road comes up. This is all publicly maintained. And there's city water back here. You've got municipal water, which is great, because anytime the power goes out, you still got water. And the views are tremendous. So 30 acres, 2,800 square foot house, 3-bedroom, 2-bath. Look at this beauty. I know you're gonna like it. Wait till you see this room here. It's like a sunroom. Wait till you see it. It's the showcase of the house. It's got wood heat, and it's got a regular heater as well. But then it's got this outdoor wood furnace. Now, what they do here is they pick up some scraps and little branches that break and things like that on the farm. But you can have this block wood, which is all like 8x8 pieces, maybe a foot and a half long. You can have that delivered for about $200, $250. It would be more than enough to heat your whole place for the winter. So it's a hot water system, and it circulates the antifreeze or hot water or whatever back and forth, provides your domestic hot water, provides heat for the greenhouse all year, and heat for the house. So anyway, that's wonderful. Keeps all the smell and the mess and the dust outside, and it's like new, and they can tell you all about it. It's all stainless steel. Very cool. All right, we're gonna go inside, but I kind of wanted to show you this. The property line here, let me zoom out. The property line, see, there's like one or two swaths cut there with the hay machine. That's where the property line is, and it goes up to this spot right here on the road, and it goes down the road, includes that whole field. So you see that tree row there? That's the end of the property. It goes up and over, way in the back. Very nice. There's some pine trees there that are included in the property, and that comes along that back line. Now, what's key about that field there is about 12 acres, And that 12-acre field can be subdivided off. You could build a house or two or three up in there, but you've got this road frontage, and Boyle County will let you subdivide that off back up there. So if you need a second house or a third house or just some potential retirement income where you need to lop off a piece of land, you can do that. And then the rest of the land is all out here out front, and then it goes behind the house and behind the barns, and there is a there's a very cool pond back here. So let me just show you the tomatoes real quick. You're gonna want to see this. So here are the koi ponds, and then there's a waterfall here. I'll show you more of that later. And then that pond is right there. You see the canoe and that rope swing. And then check out these tomatoes. This is so cool. I've always grown up in the country, but I've never seen tomatoes go up to 8 feet like this. Is this cool? They just picked another 400 pounds of tomatoes, and they get sent to CSAs and organic stores. It's a organic farm, and Dan can tell you more about that. But they got little babies growing here already. So I assume they've got tomatoes all year round. But how cool is this, right? And those rascals just go up. They grow up these strings. They're 8 feet tall. There's not many better smells than the smell of that tomato plant. Love that. And look at these. Aren't they gorgeous? Gorgeous. All organic. Nothing sprayed, nothing in the ground, just fertilizer, you know, real fertilizer, not chemical fertilizer, real stuff. Manure and compost and that sort of thing. And now we've come around back from the front of the house, and we come to this bread oven, which I think is the coolest. I'm just into that, baking my own bread, I mean, pizza. The 25 loaves will fit in here. This is a big oven. And look at this view. Can you imagine sitting out here, making your own bread, having a glass of wine? Here we go with the wine again, right? So, and then here's a party area. This is the shed. This is the machine shed. And then you've got, you know, for the lawnmower and all that sort of thing. But this is the party area. How cool is this? When I see this, I think of like a pool house. So wait till I show you over there. You're going to really like that. So you've got a sink here and a grill. Little refrigerator, TV, lighting, super. And I'm not going to show my wife this crepe myrtle because she loves crepe myrtle. Now, as you come back from the barn, that's where my truck's parked, the property line doesn't go too far behind that barn. And then it comes down here, not this fence, but there's another fence about 50, 75 feet on the other side. And that's the end of the property line where that telephone pole, that power pole is. And then it shoots down here to this road on the other side of the road. This is your road. And it shoots down to that point around there in that field. So 30 acres, that's a lot of land. Let's go on inside. Okay, here we go. Now, three bedrooms, two full baths, 2,800 square foot. This house is huge. It's got these old style cabinets, lots and lots of countertop, lots of cabinet space. And what I like a lot is this eat-in area. Look at this. There's your view. Can you imagine having coffee, looking at that every morning? And then, of course, there's the bread oven right there. So you can be right out here, a lot of entertaining. Here's laundry, and I assume this is a laundry chute. And then you've got master closet there, right off of the bath. Wait till you see that, it's a walk-in guy. And then from the kitchen here, there's the front door. And you've seen pictures of the porch, with the doggy on the porch. It's such a beautiful view. And then this is like a man's room. This is, he's got the fireplace, it's got the paneling, the beams on the ceiling, hardwood floors. This is just beautiful. So use it as a library or a cigar smoking room or whatever you want, but wait till you see, I'm gonna show you the millwork on the other side here. Raised panels, this arch, and this is my favorite room. Got wood stove, All tile floor, wood stove, and that rascal, I bet, will heat the whole house. Now you've got one of those outdoor wood furnaces here as well, and that heats the whole house and the greenhouse. And I'll talk to you more about that when I'm outside. But that's really a nice thing. But this wood stove here, you got the glass door, you can see it's like, you know, a fireplace and wood stove, best of both worlds. But look at this millwork. I'm really impressed with that and the ceiling. So the room of many windows. So in the winter time, if you ever need to cheering up, you just come right on out here. It's so big, you can put a pool table here, or they have a ping pong table. Let's just pop outside here real quick. So here are the koi ponds. Here's that party area, the entertaining area, and you got koi ponds and a waterfall and everything. And there's the greenhouse right there, filled with tomatoes. Wait till you see those. I'm gonna take you out there as well. Okay, now through this den, which is pretty big. Let me show you how big this is. That's a big room. And then this bathroom here is great. It's got the wainscoting on the bottom and full one-piece tub and shower here. And I just love this openness here. This is really nice, light and airy feeling. Now these treads are oak, but I can't put my finger on this wood on the floor. It's maybe some kind of a nut wood. It's beautiful. Let's go on out here to find. Is it a lazy day today? Snuggles. Dog's name is Snuggles. It's pretty funny. But here you're overlooking all your land. So property goes up against those trees. And that's a long way out there. I'm gonna guess, I don't know, 800 feet or so. I mean, that's truly a guess. Might be 900, 700, I don't know, but it's far. I wouldn't want to walk it. But there is a walking trail cut with a lawnmower, and I don't know where it starts, but it goes all the way along back there. It's 0.7 miles. So you can go out and walk in the morning, and you're so far out here in the country. I mean, oh, just, it's God's country out here. This is God's place. Let's go back in. Okay, so as soon as you come in the front door, just to the left here is this very cool bathroom. You got cedar, which you can smell. That western red cedar, it's just fantastic. Jet tub, and then check this out. Two or three steps down into the shower. And when I tell you, you can have six of your best friends in here, you can have six of your best friends. It's huge. How cool is that? And hopper. And then here's the walk-in. So, and these are with sensor lights, which is great because my wife always forgets to shut off her closet light. Drives me crazy, right? It's a short drive, I know, but this is with sensor. All the lights come on with a sensor. I love that. You don't have to fool with anything. And then right back out to the laundry room again from this side. Now we saw outside, we saw that wood furnace. Well, let me just tell you what's going on here. You've got a central heat and air system here. It's geothermal. So you know how that works. It goes into the ground and it pulls heat from the ground, which is always at 58. Heat pumps work great, but once they get down below 35 or so, they don't work very well. The geothermal always is pulling from 58 degrees. So it's easy to heat or cool when you got a 58 degree constant. So that's like the best system you can get. Now let's add a layer of coolness on top of it and throw that wood furnace out there. There's the heat exchanger for you people who like all this geeking out on this stuff. There's the heat exchanger. So in these pipes are antifreeze and that run out to the wood stove, and it's got a coil there, and then the pump pumps it up through here, and then you've got the heat exchanger there. And it also runs the domestic hot water So very cool, and you can truly live off the grid with a very light generator, just running these circulator pumps. Anyway, the sellers can tell you more about it. Dan can tell you more about it, but I wanted to share that with you real quick.
Okay, so there's the bathroom, master bath, and then here's the master bed. Serene. So you wake up in the morning, you open your eyes, and you look out over those fields. Remember those fields from outside? Just beautiful. Look at that. So let's go on upstairs. I'll show you what we got up there. We got two nice bedrooms in this airy feel. Love this.
So this bedroom is all paneling, which not a big deal. If you like paneling, great. And if you don't like paneling, paint is cheap. And I'll show you what it looks like painted. There you go. Now, how cute is that for a little girl or someone who just likes pink? And that's just paint right on the paneling. Beautiful. Good solution if you don't like that dark paneling. All metal roof. Look at that. I love a tin roof. First of all, they don't ever seem to go bad. And another thing is, it sounds so nice with the rain on the tin roof. That's about living in the country. That's all part of it.
One of my favorite places in this farm is this area back here. Of course, I got a lot of favorite places, like the bread oven that holds 25 loaves of bread or pizzas. I mean, gosh, can you imagine making your own pizza on a wood-fired oven? We got this playhouse, and it's a real house. It's got power and everything. See the screen door and the power and the swing? Now, we've had a drought, so the pond is really low right now. But you've got this rope swing. How cool is that? Get up there, and you just do a Geronimo. And it's got a canoe, and it's like a kidney shape, goes around to the barn. That's the end of the property. I have no idea what's on the other side, but I imagine it's thousands and thousands of acres that are untouched, unspoiled. This is one of those places that you're way out there, way out in the country. You know, you're way out in the country, but you're only, what, 15 minutes to Danville, 20 minutes to Danville? This is